Hey guys, so last time we talked about a simple linear regression where we only have one independent variable and one dependent. But this time let's take a look at a real world example where obviously we have many independent variables. All right, so I think it's best to just dive right in with an example. So let's start and talk about house prices, right? We have our price, the dependent variable, right? And we'll call it y, y1. And we have our independent variables, the things that affect the price. So let's start with, let's say x1 will be our area of the house, right? The square feet area, 1, 1. x2, 1 will be what? Number of bedrooms, let's say, right? Bedrooms. The third variable we'll say is, I don't know, what should we call it? Number of bedrooms. Age, let's say age of the house, how old it is. And the fourth one, let's say the area of the yard, right? Obviously there's many more factors, but these are the ones that we can quantify. Now there's some combination that each of these variables has an effect on the final price. Obviously the bigger the house, the more expensive it is. The more bedrooms, the more expensive it is. The newer, the more expensive it is, but not always, because Victorian houses, as you guys know, are pretty cool. And yard, obviously the bigger the yard, the more expensive the house will be. So here, why I wrote one everywhere, that's our first observation. So we have our first house, it has some square feet, it has some bedrooms, it's whatever years old, and it has a yard. Maybe it doesn't, so this would just be zero, whatever. So now we have our second observation, y2. We have another house that costs something, and now we have our first variable, but the second one, so the index, the first index is the variable. And then here we have x2, 2, x3, 2, and x4, 2. So it's the same area, bedrooms, age, and yard, but now it's the second observation everywhere, right? And we can just keep doing this for whatever data set we have. Let's say k, we have k observations. So it goes down to x1, k, x2, k, x3, k, and x4, k. The index k here meaning however many number of observations that we have. And the number of variables in this case is obviously 4, right? Area, bedrooms, age, and yard. Now, to get this into the working order that we need to transpose this matrix. And check out that video if you haven't already and you're not sure how to do that. So if we do that, if we transpose it, we call that matrix X, and it's written like this. Obviously, this is just switched around. So we have X1, 1, all the way over to X1, K, right? Because we have K observations. And let's generalize and say here we had N equals 4, but let's generalize. So this would be XN equals N1, not equals, sorry, the index, because it's the nth variable. Here we just had 4, but I mean, you can just extend this out. And then it would go all the way over to XNK. All right, does that make sense? We have N variables, N independent variables. We can just extend yard, whatever else, neighborhood, even though I don't know how you would quantify neighborhood. And then K observations. It can be whatever amount of houses that you're looking at with the different with a different criteria. So this is X. We call this matrix X of the independent variables. Then this Y, we write like this. We write it Y1 all the way down to YK, right? Because we have K observations. Now, we're almost done. The extended form looks like this of the linear regression. Yi equals beta 0, which I'm sure you remember from the last video, plus beta 1 xi 1, because it's the ith observation, right? Plus beta 2 xi 2, because it's the second variable of the ith observation, plus so on and so forth until we get to the end. Beta n, because n variables, right? xin, because it's the ith observation, the ith house that you're looking at, and it's the nth variable that you're taking into account, which has an effect on the price. And then just like before, we have plus the error term. Now, there's a couple things left that we haven't written down yet. First of all, the beta. How do we calculate the betas? Each one of these betas, because they're estimates, right? Just like from before, we draw the little hats here. And they're given by this really crazy formula, which we're not gonna derive because it takes too much time, but all you really need to know is the actual formula. And the formula for the matrix of the betas, right, which looks like this. Beta 0 all the way down to beta n looks like x transposed, right? Remember transpose, you can check out that video, times x. You can also check out the video on how to multiply matrices. Inverse, check out our video on how to take the inverse of a matrix, times x transposed and times y, this matrix. And that's how these betas are figured out. So this is just a short introduction on a multi-linear regression where you have more than one independent variable. And honestly, when I was first learning this, I thought that house prices was the best example because it's very intuitive. It's something that we've all seen before. So that's it. I hope you guys like this video. Click like, click subscribe, and stay geekly, my friends.